Hey guys, patch day today. So patch 2.2 has been officially out. It's actually finishing the download now on my Plarium client, and it's out. We have the forge. So rip to the campfire. We won't have the campfire anymore. And I know the question that everyone else has is, where are they gonna put the Christmas tree in December? I don't know. Guys, they used to put the Christmas tree right there in the middle where the campfire is. Now there's a huge problem with the game. We don't know where the Christmas tree is gonna be. So for now, we just have to use the forge. So guys, the forge is the new addition to the game that's been huge, especially for newer players, in my opinion. I'll quickly take you through the forge and how it works. I haven't used it yet, so I'm gonna use it right now for you guys to see. So there's four sets at the time being that are available to everyone. There's the Swift Parry set, Deflection, Resilience, and Perception set. My opinion, the best set out of all of these is the Perception set. It's the best one for everyone starting out in the game. It basically has a ton of accuracy and some good amount of speed. Not as much speed as, of course, a speed set, but still a 5% is much better than zero. So getting some accuracy, getting some speed is gonna help a ton of new players. So you guys see that there are some requirements now to craft these items. We'll start from the top. So you need this Magisteel. This is just taken from Classic Arena at the time being. So every time you win, you get up to 2 to 4 for gold 4, which is the arena where I'm currently at. If you're in Platinum, you get 3 to 5. Then you can also get this Core Hammer, which you can get this from events and tournaments. And you get this Legendary Soulstone only from Faction Wars. And also from Faction Wars, you get this legendary crafting materials, which is this one's called Legendary Bloodstone. And there's also the Epic Bloodstone, which can also be you can also get this from Faction Wars as well. So in my opinion, everyone should just keep hoarding these materials until we see maybe more players actually crafting them. We learn a bit about the rates, and then we decide if it's definitely worth it, see the sets actually in action. Me personally, I'm gonna hoard this for a bit and then start crafting them. I'm just gonna possibly craft one or two right now just to show you, but the difference in the pricing, the requirements is so huge, guys. So look at this, it takes 50 of this material of Magisteel to craft one Swift Parry, and that's reasonable because this is a Platinum tier reward. The same thing with Deflection, so 50 of the Magisteel. So it's gonna take a couple of fights, at least 10 fights every single day, just to craft one item and also do your Faction Wars and also possibly competing in events and tournaments. And for these Resilience set, you don't even need to compete anywhere, so it's just from Faction Wars and Arena. And Perception, again, Faction Wars and Arena, but these are much cheaper, so it takes 5, 10, and 5 instead of 50, 10, and 10, which is, these are double and these are 10 times. So there's a huge difference with these and these. So newer players should go for these two and older players should go for these two up at the top. So crafting chances is where you see actually the chances needed to craft every single item along with the substats. So it's 10% for each substat, which is cool. And I mean, it's reasonable. It makes sense, specifically for each substat. And you can increase this with these items, guys. So the rank charms help you get a higher rank. So the highest rank will be, for example, 6-star. And the rarity will get you legendary items, which is the highest. And then you can pick and try to get the specific weapon, helmet, shield, or whatever. Or you just leave it at random. And then the substat is when you specifically try to get a specific substat. So far I've gotten these charms. So HP charm, attack charm, and the speed charms are the ones that everyone will be looking for. And of course the other ones, critical damage charm will also be possibly really good, critical rate. Actually, you can only put one of these in there, so you can't put two, it replaces the other one. So you have to be very careful in which ones you need. For example, a blender team might need critical rate and critical damage, but you know, speed teams will need, you know, the speed charm instead. And of course, you know, you can change these as well. So possibly crafting an item would take all of these. So let us very quickly craft an item just to see the animation. I haven't seen it yet. So I'm gonna do one perception at random. I'm not gonna select any of these just to see how it works. Oh, look at that. That's a nice animation. And we get a 6-star rare helmet. That's quite bad. I mean, the subsets are bad. So let's do another one. Hopefully we don't get a helmet, so we get a full set. So a 5-star there. That's cool. Because we selected the highest difficulty, if you go to the lowest one, it just takes 1 and 10, which is quite cool. I mean, I think, just going for the 5 to 6-star is going to be the best thing for newer players. Even if you get a rare, it's still going to be worth it. So you can increase your chances of getting a good item. Overall, I really like the Forge and I can't wait to see way more sets in here. Next up, guys, we've got a ton of events and tournaments going on today. There's been a ton of issues today with the patch, the players crashing. You know, we have the new Dungeon Diaries event. You couldn't see, you couldn't pick up the rewards. Actually finish this really quickly, and everybody should try to finish it because it's only for 2 days, but it's a very low amount of points needed and you get a ton of rewards. These ones are also needed for crafting, so be sure to pick those up. There's also another dragon tournament going on, so we have 2 dragon tournaments going on at the same time, so you can actually pick double rewards if you fight in it. I already did some fights here. I'm already number 1 and hoping to get, you know, the type charm x20. And also the rank charm x5. That would be cool. Although, look at this. Rarity charm x20. I don't know which one is better. So, the rarity charm or the rank charm. I mean, the rank charm probably going to help you get more 6-stars. But we'll see. We'll see. I haven't seen the global rewards. Yeah, the global rewards are just shards and an epic skill book. Okay. So, overall, the patch so far has been great. Of course, the rebalancing has been activated. And you guys should expect to see some videos out of me for guides on champions that have been reworked, for example Rotos, for example Cadrophone, which is the one that I expect to see the most amount of difference since the patch. Let's go and see my Cadrophone right here. There he is, my Cadrophone. I have him already level 60, fully ascended savage set, and he's ready to roll with 224 critical damage and 5000 attack. So we're gonna see how much damage he does. I don't think I actually maxed him out, so I might need to max him out just to see the full damage potential. But it's still going to give me a good idea of how he works. One of the things we have in the patch, guys, is an additional champion in the game. So look at this, guys. The new champion, Saito, is in the game. He's a very strange champion. I don't know what he's going to be about because we didn't get any info about this. Possibly he's going to be a fusion champion. But let's go over his skills very quickly. He's an attack-based legendary. Applies a defense down at a 50% chance with his A1 and plays an extra hit if the decreased defense debuff is placed, which is cool. So if triple hitting A1 when the defense down is applied, and his A2 attacks one enemy before attacking, plays a 50% increased attack buff and a 30% critical damage buff on this champion if this champion's defense is higher than the target's defense, which is very weird, guys, because he's an attack-based champion. It doesn't make sense for me. He's got a good amount of defense, so 1,100. So he needs to be attacking much weaker targets for this to actually work. So it does not make any sense for me. I don't know what Plarion was thinking. And also decrease the cooldown of this skill by 1 turn if the target has more than 50% HP after the attack. So yeah, I don't know. It depends on the multiplier of this, but these buffs are not going to be activated on this champion. Usually when you're attacking champions like a Krisk, there's no way you're going to have higher defense than a Krisk. Like a Valkyrie. Valkyrie can have 0 items and she'll still have more defense than this guy. So I don't know what they were thinking, and maybe they change it in the future. Let's go over and see that A3. Attacks one enemy, then attacks all enemies except the initial target if there are 3 or more enemies alive. So it's almost like a double hitting attack, but it's weird because it attacks one enemy first, the main target, and then everyone else, basically. So it should be cool in the arena. Basically, it's like an AoE, but a double hitting attack. So inflicts 20% more damage on the first hit if the target has a higher max HP than this champion. This shouldn't be very hard because his max HP is not that great. 16,000. Of course, there's lower max HP champions already in the game. And then let's look at his passive. Will ignore 7.5% of the enemy's defense for each time this champion attacks the same target enemy in consecutive attacks or turns. Stacks up to 30%. The stack will be lost and reset if this champion targets and attacks a different enemy. This will be great in some arenas where you're trying to focus down a champion. Will be great in the clan boss, in dungeons, for bosses. Try to take down an enemy that's been there for a while, that's very tanky. This helps. it does not help to basically kill multiple enemies, because the ignore defense will only apply on consecutive attacks. So great passive overall, I think. And then increases ally attack in dungeons by 30% as an aura. Nothing fantastic, but not bad either at the 30%. Depends on what you want to run in the dungeons. His animation, his model looks really cool. Somebody told me he looks like an Asian cold brew. I don't think I look like this guy, right? There's no way I look like this guy. Not even close. I mean, not even the hairstyle. Don't have a ponytail. I don't know what they were thinking. So that's it with the new champion. There's no other new champions, at least as far as I've seen. And I've already done a few arena fights today. I got my crafting materials from it. I've been doing them all day, and probably everyone else is also. And finally, guys, we also have the advanced quest. I didn't want to leave this out of this video. The advanced quest is as you go in your quest tab. I already did my dailies today, and actually I finished everything for today. So 10 quests completed. I haven't collected anything yet. I just wanted to show you. So I've got one complete all available advanced quest. That's it. I get a refresh for my energy. That's extremely cool. There's one quest, and then use 2 clan boss keys. Very reasonable also, because you need those clan boss rewards. You get a 1 type charm, you know, chest, I think. I don't know what's inside. Let's see. You receive type charm times 1. I also get a refresh for tag arena, which is cool, but it does cause other problems with the game. Oh, is this gonna crash? Next up is win 3 artifacts from clearing the dungeons. Always good. I mean, not very hard. 3 times to run a dungeon, and you get another type charm reward. You see this lag? This lag has been going on since the patch was applied. So like 5 hours for now. Fight in 5 tag team arena series, and you get 6 keys for each crypt that's open right now. So I have 2 crypts open right now. I've got the Knights Revenant and Dwarves, I think. And I should get 6 plus 6, which is so cool. Let's see. In action. Receive crypt key times 6. Some silver there. Oh man, the lag is huge. And some gems. Or beat 3 faction war stages without losing a champion. That's okay, reasonable. Make 4 accessory upgrade attempts. Also very similar to a normal quest that we have every single day. Win 30 materials in classic arena battles. And fight in classic arena with a team from a single affinity. Just, you can go in with 1 champion and lose. That's fine. It doesn't say win, so you can just go in with your speed lead. It's 1 affinity, so you can still get that. It's a nice amount of energy additionally every single day for everyone, for basically doing what you already would be doing. So very good move from Plarium. It basically means every 25 days we're going to get a legendary skill book. Those are definitely needed by players who are especially free to play. So let's go over to Faction Wars quickly and see how many keys I got. So actually it was Barbarian, so I got 6 keys there and 6 keys on Knights Revenant. That's so cool. I can basically do an endgame level 1 time and then do a 2 key stage for 1 time. So very cool overall. I like the patch. The rebalance notes are of course in the news section. If you want to see all the champions rebalance, you can go over here. I'm not going to go through these because it's not needed. Guys, thanks a lot for watching this video. If you like this video, if you like this patch, leave it down in the comments below with your thoughts. And of course, I'll also be releasing another video today about the new Faction Wars champions. We've got some details. We're gonna know what she does, and I can't wait to show you guys what she actually does for this game. Thanks a lot, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. See ya!